It just came out. It has chrome-plated shotguns and suicide and a magical car and people who turn into polar bears. I'm not going to read anything from that. I'm going to read a bunch of short things, so if you hate whatever I'm reading, it'll be over in like 2 minutes. This is called Scientific Romance. I wrote this for my wife a couple years ago on Valentine's Day. That's good. I always wait for the all. If starship travel from our Earth to some far star and back again, at velocities approaching the speed of light, made you younger than me, due to the relativistic effects of time dilation, I'd show up on your doorstep hoping you'd develop a thing for older men, and I'd ask you to show me everything you learned to pass the time out there in the endless void of night. If we were the sole survivors of a zombie apocalypse and you were bitten and transformed into a walking corpse, I wouldn't even pick up my assault shotgun. I'd just let you take a bite out of me, because I'd rather be undead forever with you than alive alone without you.
Aww.
It gets dirty, don't worry. If I had a time machine, I'd go back to the days of your youth to see how you became the someone I love so much today, and then I'd return to the moment when we first met just so I could see my own face when I saw your face for the first time, and okay, I'd probably travel to the time when we were a young couple and try to get a three-way going. I never understood why more time travelers don't do that sort of thing. If the alien invaders come and hover in stern judgment over our cities, trying to decide whether to invite us to the Galactic Federation of Confederated Galaxies, or if instead a little genocide is called for, I think our love could be a powerful argument for the continued preservation of humanity in general, or at least of you and me in particular. If we were captives together in an alien zoo, I'd try to make the best of it, cultivate a streak of xeno-exhibitionism, waggle my eyebrows, and make jokes about breeding in captivity. If I became lost in the multiverse, exploring infinite parallel dimensions, my only criterion for settling down somewhere would be whether or not I could find you. And once I did, I'd stay there, even if it was a world ruled by giant spider priests, or one where killer robots won the Civil War, or even a world where sandwiches were never invented. Because you'd make it the best of all possible worlds anyway, and plus we could get rich off inventing sandwiches. If the singularity comes and we upload our minds into a vast computer simulation of near infinite complexity and perfect resolution, and become capable of experiencing any fantasy, exploring worlds bound only by our enhanced imaginations, I'd still spend at least 10 to the 21 processing cycles a month just sitting on a virtual couch with you, watching virtual TV, eating virtual fajitas, holding virtual hands, and wishing for the real thing. So that was a happy one. Here's a sad one.